Here on St Helena, the ocean's a big part of everybody's life. During the school holidays, everybody will at least swim in the sea once. That's how big the ocean is to everyone. As soon as we could, we were in the water. So the Papanui is a shipwreck that sits in James Bay. The wreck itself is cool, but once you actually put a mask on and start swimming around, there's a whole different ballgame. You've got fish right in front of you that, honestly, they get on like you're not even there. Fish are very unique in the sense that not very many people get to experience them. When you're under the water and you can stay and fish come out, there's a lot more that people aren't seeing. So I've always been interested in becoming a marine biologist or somebody in the marine industry. Here on St Helena, learning to dive isn't cheap. For me, still being a student, it's the equivalent of a whole month paycheck. But to become a scuba diver would definitely help me to get that job that I've always wanted. In the paper, I saw that there was a dive scholarship that people were offering. So as soon as I saw it, I sent the people an email to say that I'm interested. They emailed me back saying, yeah, come down, have an interview with us, see what happens, and give it a go. Hearing the news that I got the scholarship is numerous different emotions that start going through your mind. Where is this going to take me? What will I do with it? Couldn't wait to get started. Putting everything on for the first time, you feel like you're in a movie or some main character. Where you get like the slow-mos and the Baywatch and everyone's looking at you. As soon as you jump in and all the bubbles have cleared, there's the hesitation, but as soon as you take that first breath, your body just relaxes and feel at ease. It definitely made it feel a lot more natural than with fins and swimming around, looking at stuff, almost like a fish yourself. Couldn't wait to do my first sea dive.
All right, guys, welcome again. So we are going to do our open water dive number two. First of all, it's going to be a wreck dive in the Papanui. Skills, the main one's going to be a full mast flood and removal.
In training, the part I did struggle with was the mast removal. Taking the mast off wasn't the issue, it was the water starting to go up into my nose. But after repeating the drill quite a few times, just managed to take the mask off, put it back on, easy peasy. The course itself lasted just under a month. The final thing we did was the compass drill. So just swim 10, 20 meters with a compass, swim back. After that, got to swim around, and what's going through my mind is that I finished it. I'm a diver, basically. Doing the dive course definitely changed my perspective of a few things. Going into the caves, swimming with fish that you can reach out and touch and they won't even move. but going out on the boat and people saying that fish aren't how they used to be, kind of makes you want to be that past in Detroit, help change that.
In school, I'm currently studying marine science. That, along with being a scuba diver, that's one of the small steps I'm taking to hopefully get that good job that makes an impact.
A lot of people say, no, don't go for conservation, the pay isn't good, gotta go for a high-paid job, but I'd definitely like to try and restore the island back to what it was 50-plus years ago. To help bring fish back and help save the environment and to help future generations see what I see.